me. Softus has brought the RG right over here right now. What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today in the fog, doing stuff and things on the Pooping Evolved Ark Survival Evolved server. I hope you guys are having a good day. What level are you? I'm going to use this, even though I can just walk right up. 60? You're amazing. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. I just got to be recording some fun stuff that you're going to see later on today. So, pretty cool. I'm pretty excited. I'm pretty pumped. And I logged on the server, and it's kind of foggy. So, I thought it was time to have a fiber party. Let's do it! Oh man, too much fiber party. Passed out. And we're back. I just wanted to start stuff off with a bang kind of for you guys. I'm excited to do some stuff and things today. We're going to do some building. So yeah, I wanted to get some fiber going. We need to make some stuff and things. We need to make some wood pillars because we're going to kind of build out of thatch and wood to do our test, to do some testing today. But yeah, so yeah, hope you guys are having a great day, and we're back from passing out. I didn't realize you could actually pass out from having a fiber party. That was my first fiber party. And yeah, I want to start off today by saying, as I always do, thank you guys so very much for all your likes and support in the videos. Really means a lot to me, and I really, really appreciate it. If you guys like this video, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. Thumbs up for fiber party. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more daily ARK stuff and things and other stuff and things. We're still doing Mad Max. There's some new games on the horizon I'm kind of excited for. But today, we're going to start off with doing some building finally. You know, I've been kind of putting off the building because I've been a little bit apprehensive. I'll be honest with you. This is my first giant wooden building or metal building project, and I'm a little bit apprehensive. I wanted to get a big stockpile of stuff and things, and I was a little bit worried about, like, honestly, how it was going to turn out. I'm like, I don't know if this is going to be good. I don't know if this is going to be really cool. And I want it to be super cool. But you know what? I had an epiphany. I had a thought, epiphany, moment, place type thing. And what I realized was that sometimes there are things that are unknown that you need to do. And the best thing that you can do is just try to prepare yourself as best you can and have the greatest and funnest time you can doing stuff and things. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to start off, we're going to play smart, not hard. We're going to use some thatch ceilings and some wooden pillars to kind of set down our foundations and kind of scope out what we've got going on. I also have done some other stuff and things, and I actually don't think I can show you right now because I can't walk. We've got like 700 polymer made up. We had 250 the other day when we did the polymer and electronics episode. And then I went behind the scenes and made a bunch more. Over here, you can't really see, well you can, but it took me like, I think we made an additional 450 polymers, so that was like 900 more cementing paste. And then I've gone ahead and made a bunch more cementing paste as well. And we've got metal in and about the area doing it. We've got a bunch I brought down from the forge up on the mountain. And then we've also, I went over to the mountain right over here and harvested a bit more. So you can see, I think probably right inside of here, we've already got some more metal, hot metal action as well. So we're doing really good. We got a bunch of stuff and things going. So I was trying to think of how the best way or what the best way would be to do this, how we're going to start the build, how it's going to end up looking. And what I think I want to do is obviously have like a cool thing right on the top here, something like this. We got to tear down this pillar too, but something kind of cool on the top here. But one of the things I want to do is come from the top right here-ish to an area where there's an elevator that comes down to a spot where we load and unload our dinos. Now, this is going to be kind of tough because this is all slopey and kind of wacky, and the elevator's got to go straight out. But that's kind of some of the stuff I want to see. I'm not sure how much we're going to be able to get done in a day today, but that's where I wanted to start off with today. Good scrap! Can I move? Wait, no. There. Nailed it. Nailed that landing! And so over here, now we've got all these pillars. How many did I end up making? 29. And then we've got 75 thatch roofs that we made the other day. Just because I had some extra stuff and things on me. And I figured we might as well do that to get ready. So what I'm thinking about up here is, you can see this is a little bit of like an L shape. See what I'm talking about right there? So I think this might be a great spot to kind of start off. Oh crap, did I not bring any of the thatch foundations? I think I have a couple of those. I only really need one. So let's go ahead down here and take a look again. Thatch foundation, nailed it! And then we'll come back up and we'll start laying out the road map. We'll start laying out the test area. So up in this early direction, we kind of want to select, I think, the middle area, because the elevator is going to be like an odd numbered thing. So it's either going to be one wide, I do believe, or like two wide, or like one and a half. You know what I mean? Like, it's not a two wide structure. I guess what I'm trying to say, it's a one wide structure. So if we take a look right here, and let's just go ahead and go like this. Take this guy. Is this the middle? You know what we'll do is we will go like this. We'll go into our K mode. We'll zoom way, way out so we can kind of get an idea of where the middle of this is. So I think we're going to turn a little bit more. Actually, let's look in like so. There we go. So now we've got to try to kind of find the middle of this area, and we want to put this out as far as we can and not have it be obstructed by the ground like so. So that looks pretty good right there. Let's go ahead and place it. Nailed it, Ace, it can't be stopped. Let's go ahead and take a fly up really quick and kind of get a bird's eye view of what this looks like. And we are actually on a bird. So this bird's eye view is actually a bird's eye view. So this looks pretty good to me. I'm liking it. I'm picking up what I'm putting down. All right, so we got that there. Then let's go ahead and grab some of our ceilings. And we will start placing these guys down like so and like so. And I kind of want to see how this line looks and see if this all lines up. So now I'm going to pop back up here like so and take a look at it. I think that's good. I think that's good, peeps. It looks really cool. Like, as far as just that it's all lined up is what I'm saying. It doesn't really look that cool. But you get what I'm saying. So now what we have to do is kind of go inside of here like a so. Put these on our bar. Fly down into this early type area direction place. Too high above ground. See, this is the type of stuff in Ark that kind of is frustrating. It's not too high above the ground. It doesn't make any sense that it says that. Why are you saying that to me? Yeah, that stuff's a little bit frustrating. Let's try on this side over here. Too high above the ground. You're not, though. You're touching the ground. You're really silly, and that's... And this one says it, too. This stinks, man. Really wish that this sort of stuff would just be... I don't know. This seems like... This is just kind of really frustrating. So I can put one there. And I kind of can't put one here. No matter what I do, I can't get it to go down. And then it's giving me that too high above the ground message. Well, you know what? I guess it's just alerting you. Ah! And we're back. As I was saying before, I was so rudely interrupted by video game gravity. I guess it's just a learning experience. But then I went ahead. I had to make a bunch more pillars. Already used. Over here on hardware, I've got like 60 pillars made. And I think I've already used like... 30, 40? This build is going to be a work in progress for sure. But I got this out to a point now where I feel like if we were to come back up into this early direction, like so, and we take a look over the edge, don't fall off gravity! We could put our elevator here-ish, I think. And this is going to be really... I know it's going to be difficult. We're going to have a... I feel like I'm going to have a hard time getting this to line up in place correctly. But we're going to do our very, very best. We're going to see what we can do here using the pillars to make sure we line stuff and things up. It's fixing to be night. Game of fours. There we go. We can see. But I'm feeling like this is a thing. Like, we can come down here, and then we'll be good to go there. Now, if we take a look, we're going to need... I want to put an elevator right here. And I feel like it's going to be... like 20 elevator tracks, probably. I'm not exactly sure. But what I want to kind of try to do is from this area right here, I want to see, can we place, okay, we can place some ceilings on here. And then this way, we can line up the two builds. See what I'm doing here? So now at least you can see we're kind of lining stuff and things up. So I can like go like this now and kind of come out. You see what I'm talking about? We can come out here like so, and then maybe put a couple pillars here, and then put a ceiling. Well, one will snap there. I want to get it to snap lower, though. I really wish that it would, so we could make this line up better. But we actually, at least we have something that we can do here. I want to get down so that we're lined up at ground level. So maybe we'll try like this, like this, like this. That ain't gonna work. What if we break this? And then build this halfway in between. No, wait, what? Build this like so. Now, can we place one? No, we can't. So, kind of wanted to get it to line up pretty good. Guess we're going to have to play around that a little bit more. But we got a solid beginning, peeps. We got a definitely got a solid beginning. And we're back in the wee hours of the morn. And we're pixin' to start doing some stuff and things. 3, 4, 5, 6... 7, 8, 9, 1,000. Let's just grab 1,000. Oh my god, I can't even believe I just put 1,000 cementing paste. That's a lot. That's a lot. So we're going to come over here now. And I had all my guys all lined up and beautiful, by the way, for you guys. I think I was going to do that and show it to you in another episode, and it never happened. And then something came to the base, and now they're all everywhere. Anyway, all right. So we're going to start building some elevator tracks now. We're going to need them. We're going to need a bunch of them, so we might as well start building them. And especially one of the things that you got to take into account when you're building stuff and things is you want to be in the area. So if we have to go gather other things or do that, we don't want to be away from here, because we're going to get a lot of experience for this. So let's go ahead and turn the fabricator on. Let's go under, what is it, structures, electrical, elevators. Bam, we can make 9 tracks right now, because I mean, the 1,000 cementing paste, we've got what? It's 25 per. So... that's 40 tracks, if I got my math right. But it's the metal ingots. It's 140 metal ingots per. So let's go ahead and craft one of these up. Let's take a look here. We're at 307 experience. What? You're kidding me! Oh, that's a bug. That's like 2.5 experience per. 140 metal ingots. Yeah, that seems like a very small amount, but okay, so we're going to go ahead and start getting these going. But I figured what we would do is I have to move back and forth over here. Wait, do I have metal on me? No, I don't. We're just on a slow bird. We've got to kind of come over here. I was expecting it to be much more experience, like 20 or 40 maybe per. But all right, so anyhoozle. So we're going to go ahead and grab some... can I get right back on you right now? All right, we're going to grab our metal ingots like so. And then while it's crafting, so we can get the... I guess it doesn't really matter at this point. We want to be in the area to get the 14 experience. I was expecting it to be like hundreds. But yeah, it's kind of the same thing what I do when I'm making cementing paste or something like that. But all right, so we're going to craft. We're going to come down here. We got 600 more ingots. Let's see here. If we squirt 600 more of these on, we'll go to structures, electrical, elevators, and we can make 4 more tracks. So that would be a total of, what, 13? I want to try to get, I think, 20 going. So I'm going to go ahead and grab some more metal. We're going to make 1 or 2 more trips. This elevator track is going to, oh my gosh. I mean, we do have like 60 floors and 60 pillars already, but this is going to almost clear us out for metal here. I bet. Yeah, this is crazy, man. We'll grab 600 more and we're going to have to make a couple more trips. But, yeah, 20 tracks is what I want, and I want to put the biggest elevator, the heaviest one, on this. And I think we're going to have a couple more elevators in the base here, but just in different spots. But I want the heaviest elevator to be at this area right here. If I want to bring something huge up to the top, this is the spot we're going to do it. So we'll have to see how much that costs, too. You know what? Let's go ahead and do that right now together and see. I can't move. I can't move even a little bit. All right, we'll go ahead and come over here now. Drop these guys on. And drop these guys on. Like so. Structures, electrical, elevators. So the big one, the large elevator, takes 800 metal ingots. That's crazy. Crazy! Well, we're going to do it. It's going to be cool. The biggest concern I have is just in some way, and I'm not sure how the heck I'm going to do this, is getting it lined up. And I'm really hoping that... that I can find an easy way to do it. I have an idea. I have an idea for an easy way that we can make it happen. But I'm not exactly sure. So we're going to have to play around with it. But all right, let's go over here on tonnage. We got one more trip to make. And we should be good to go. Oh, also, by the way, I wanted to let you guys know, I have been checking my stegos every once in a while. Oftentimes, I find they haven't laid many eggs. I think we've got now 6 or 8 stego eggs for kibble. Once we have around, I think, I don't know. I got to look back at the video where we tamed Foul Play and see exactly how much we're going to need. I think maybe 10 or a little bit more than that. We're going to start really keeping our eyes peeled for a new RG. So, all right, go like that. Structures, electrical, elevators, the large elevator. Let's make one of these. Let's take a look here. 3-3, or basically 340. Wow. 2 experience. I can't believe it's that little. Should be way more than that. So now we're going to have 16 tracks. I think I want to make 2 more tracks. And then... yeah, then we should be good to kind of probably start getting this sussed out, figuring out how our floor is going to look down here and making it all attach up at the top. So I'm going to do that, and then I'll be our bees, peeps. And we're back! All right, guys. I got some stuff and things on me here. Let me see here. I got some more. I'll tell you something else. Hold on. I'm going to tell you something else I did first. So I built the top platform out one more because it was actually one back from this. So, like, now the edge of this ceiling is the edge of the platform up above, but it was one back further. So if I was trying to put an elevator like up here, see, it just wouldn't like match. It would be bad. So I decided to do like here. Now, oh, baby, is that like right? Oh, man. Now, let me see here. That's backwards. And you can't E it. Oh, no, what? 120 RG? We're taking a break from building BRBs. And we're back. Oh, my gosh, guys. So much stuff and things are happening. XB brought a egg over for me. Softis has brought the RG right over here right now. Oh, no! And we're back. And I've shot the Argentavis in the head with my gun, with my bullet gun, this bullet gun right here with the scope on it. In my defense, as you can see on my hot bar now, in the number 4 slot is my Trank gun. In the number 5 slot is my bullet gun. In the footage previously, which I will play back for you now, you can see that this is clearly not the case. They have been switched. Now, I don't think anybody can switch that when I'm offline. I don't know. I don't think anybody maliciously came by and switched my guns. I think there's some sort of bug going on. And this actually happened to me before. I think in a video night, I looked around for it, but I couldn't find it. But I have always kept my Trank on my 4 slot. Always, always, always. And in that video, the rifle was in my 4 slot. Now, yes, the scope was a huge giveaway. I should have seen that, but I was hyper-focused on the RG and just making sure I made the shot. And actually, if for a split second as I brought the gun up, right as I was going to fire, like right now, right at that moment, I kind of sort of had a feeling something was wrong. But don't worry, peeps. It was a mistake, but we will do better next time. So, moving on in our video for today, we're trying to place this elevator. And I got to tell you guys, we may need to take a break from this because this is really some frustrating stuff going on with this elevator. So, all right, let me try to take a look at this. You know what? I may just place one of these so you can see, because it's so hard to tell when they're green. Oh, look at that right there. See, that's what I want. That's what I want right there. Maybe we can still do it. So, I guess I'll just place one so you can see it. All right. So, this is the back of the track that has the X's. This is the front of the track that does not. This is where the elevator would go. I have it right here, and we should... oh, you can see right there, it's snapped on, but it won't place because it's obstructed. But this is where the large elevator would go, and it would hook onto this side. You can see the little... let me go like this. You can see the little bits that are squirted onto those little long... the little pole bits, and that's how it places, right? So if I try to place one over here, you'll see right here, the back faces me. That's not what I want. I want the back of the elevator to be here. So I would be facing the back now. The elevator would be right here, and you'd get on it, and it would take you all the way up to the top there, right? So if I try to place it here, it does do this thing where it snaps, which is great. And if it snapped the other direction, it would be perfect. I'm pressing the E key. That does not work. Again, it may be tough for you to see, but basically it's facing the wrong direction, and there's nothing I can do about it. So if I face this direction like this, it places with that back towards that platform. If I face this direction like this, it snaps with... Wait. No, there it is. It is. It's hard. It's so hard to see. But the back is facing me, which we don't want. So it's the same either way. There the back is facing me. Here the back is facing me. I think it's so tough to see. Oh, it is. I mean, even over here, you can see if I try to place it right here, the back faces me. If I go like this and move all around, you can see it doesn't switch. There's just not a way to place it in the other direction, no matter what I try. Now, I have an idea. I'm going to try. And let's see if we get one out here. And we come right over to here. Go a little bit forward. A little bit forward. No, it won't snap. It says placement out of range. Oh, it does want to kind of snap right there. Oh, there we go. I'm trying to see if I can get it to snap. Let's fly around again. Just a little bit higher this time. Let's do this. Let's go by really far out, like so. And we'll come really far in. Like this. Stop. And we hold the X key to stop really quickly. And we'll see. It's not snapping. I was hoping that it would snap. Ugh! No, it doesn't seem to. Because down here, when I did it... Oh, you know why? Because that's a foundation, I bet. Yep, that's why. So down here, if you do it, it will kind of snap right there or right here. Exactly. That there, it snapped right there, and that would be perfect. If I could get it to snap like that on the ceiling, that would be absolutely perfect for how I want this to come to how I want this to work. And I don't feel like I have a way to make that happen. Do I have any foundations on you, homie? No. I could try to see if I can get a foundation to snap over here. Maybe. I don't know. I'm going to play around with it. I'll BRB's, peeps. And we're back. And our wolf Hungry was just killed. Right here. By friggin' raptor. It looks like there was raptors that were getting in down over in this area. So I just went around and I grabbed a couple of these guys. Made a couple of these guys. And so we're going to go and let's duck inside of here. And we're going to fortify our wall. And I think I figured something out about the elevators. So that's cool. All right, so we got a little wall in there. Let's see if we can get down inside of here. Can we get a second guy right here? This is probably a good spot, like right there. Nailed it. All right, let's go ahead and get it in here. And then like so. And that, hopefully, I don't think they should be able to fit through that area right there. That should stop him from spawning. And then he didn't really have anything on him. We'll just let that expire. So that was sad and kind of stunk. I mean, I really wanted to play around that wolf in the future. I had some ideas. But yeah, so he's gone. And we need to get a drink of water real quick. But yeah, I got to show you guys. I figured something out about how the elevator placement works. And this is kind of interesting to know. And I wish I would have known about it a few hours ago. Let's go ahead and get some water. Hot water action going. All right, so over here, check it out, guys. Let's go ahead. Oh, we got to go over to tonnage and get one of the elevator tracks. All right, let's pull these elevator, half these elevator tracks off of him. We'll stick them right here. All right, so down here, I placed a couple of foundations. This foundation I placed standing like this, okay? This foundation I placed standing like this. So if I go up to this at a viscerally angle and try to place it, see how the front faces at the direction I placed the foundation? So it doesn't matter what direction I face, the front of that elevator faces towards me in the way that I've placed the foundation. Now over here, check it out. Let's go, I'll even do it over on this side, see? See, there you can see the front of this is facing towards the front of the direction I was placing the foundation, if that makes sense. So up here, the reason that these are facing this other direction when they snap, I'm guessing, is because the original foundation that I placed up there, I placed facing this way. So the original foundation is, I do believe, making this snap in a laterally kind of way. So I don't know then. What I'm guessing is that no matter where I go, all of the elevator shafts associated with this building will try to face... Well, none of these guys are snapping. So they don't snap the ceilings. So, and they won't snap to these pillars. So you guys can't really see it here because of the no snapping rule. See, oh, I guess I could place it like that. But it's backwards. See, if I could get it to go the other way and me be here, like, I think I could eyeball it to be perfect. But anyway, like, with this, I'm going to take a wild guess, and I bet you I placed this in a this direction like this. See? Yeah, you can see. So that's what... That's, like, a really amazing piece of information for you. If you want to build something, you just got to place the your initial foundation, I guess? And it must remember that? Like, somehow? I don't know. It's really kind of weird. But that's what it feels like it's doing. So then down here, kind of the next piece of business I want to try to find out is if I was to place another foundation, and I do believe I don't have enough wood to make any more. If I was to try to place another foundation down here and I placed it facing this way, can I get it to snap the right way? So that's what I'm going to test now. And we're back! And I completely rebuilt the platform based on the new statistical evidence of foundation placement being responsible for elevator placement. As we see here and here again, you can see it. Depending on which way you place the foundation, that's which way the elevator faces. I replaced all of this, took it all down. Drax came over actually and helped me to take it all down. Oh, also, I forgot to show you guys. Drax dropped this guy off for me today. I don't know why. He just got this guy named Love Me. He's in Love Me. And he dropped him off for us. He's got a little slipgator symbol on his butt. Look, he did such a good job on the other one. Look, he did such a good job. And we got to level him up. What do we need? Health. Let's get him to 1,000 health. Oh, yeah. 1,100 health. He's going to be a killer. But anyhoozle. So, I replaced everything there. I already had a bunch of the materials in order to do it. I didn't actually realize how much I'd already built and had on tonnage, but I had to go out and gather a little bit more stuff on William Shatner. And then now, if we place this right here, and you can see this is the edge of that up there. So this, if this was one continuous, it would go from here right into there, I think. Yeah, because there'd be one. Yeah, it's perfect. Anyway, here we go. So then we just go right here. Nailed it! Aced it! Can't be stopped! Here we go! Going up! One of these! We're gonna have to get on the bird! This is turning into a thing. Do we have enough to go all the way to the top? Now, we've yet to run, like, electricity and all that stuff anyway, so we'd have to do that. There's that guy. There's that guy. That guy. That guy. Oh, baby! Oh, so close! Oh, you know what? Oh, man! I can't believe it. It's like... It's just like almost there. It's like not quite high enough. I don't know. So I guess we need one more, which we don't have. Oh my gosh. But at least we got it, guys. Like, it's been a long day of doing some construction and building. And at the very, very least now, we have our elevator going up. It may not be perfect, but it's way better than I thought it was going to turn out. So, that's going to be it for today, peeps. Thanks for hanging out with me. I hope that you had fun. I know I did. If you guys liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share favorite videos you see fit. May the stuff and things be with you. I'm going to go gather metal.